गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टू एक्टिविटीज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वन मोशन. ऑन द लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड 8.3 एंड 8.4. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इट एक्टिविटी 8.5 एंड 8.6. सर, दिस इज एक्टिविटी 8.5. इन दिस एक्टिविटी यू ऑब्जर्व दैट द डाटा रिगार्डिंग द मोशन ऑफ टू डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट्स ए एंड बी are given in table 8.1. This is table 8.1. Now it is asked to examine them carefully and state whether the motion of the objects is uniform or non-uniform. So let us see the data first. In the first column, the times are given. In the second column, the distance traveled by object A in meter is given. And in the third column, the distance traveled by the object D in meter is given. Now we have to check which one, the object A or object B, is in uniform motion, and also which object A or object B is in non-uniform motion. So observe carefully first the time interval. If you observe carefully the time interval, so it is 9:30 a.m., 9:45 p.m. time interval for 15 minutes. Now 9:45 a.m. to 10 a.m. time interval again is 15 minutes. Now the time interval here also 15 minutes. Now from 10:15 to 10:30 the time interval is 15 minutes. Now 10:30 to 10:45 the time interval is 15 minutes. Here also the time interval between 10:45 to 11 is 15 minutes, means that time intervals are same. Now look here, the distance covered. So the distance traveled by the object A, it is at a distance of 10 meter milestone. After 15 minutes, it is at 20 meter milestone. So in 15 minutes, it covers a difference of 10 meter. If you find the difference, 20 minus 10, so it comes out to be 10 meter. Now in the next 15 minutes we find the difference in the distance of 30 minus 20, again 10 meter. Now in this 15 minutes again the difference is 40 minus 30, that is 10 meter. Here again in 15 minutes the difference of the distances, that is 50 minus 30, 10 meter. Here also for 15 minutes the difference is 10 meter. Here also for 15 minutes time interval the difference in distances is same, that is 10 meter. So what kind of motion this object is performing? According to definition of uniform motion, the equal distances are being covered in equal intervals of time. So this object A, it is performing uniform motion. Okay, now coming to the object B. So you observe here that in the same time interval, here time intervals are same for this also, but the distances covered, let us see. For this 15 minutes time interval, the distance covered is 12 meter. But for next 15 kilometer, for next 15 minutes, the distance covered is 19 minus 12, that is 7 meter. But for this time interval, again 15 minutes, the distance covered is 23 minus 19, that is equal to 4 meter only. Now for the same time interval 15 minutes again, the difference between 35 and 23, that comes out to be 12 meter. So here you get 7 meter, here you get 4 meter, here you get 12 meter. Now for next time interval, same time interval 15 minutes, here the difference is 37 minus 35, that is 2 meter. For next time interval 15 minutes, the difference here 41 minus 7, that is 4 meter. Now here for next 15 minutes, the difference is 3 meter. So you observe that the time intervals are same, but the distances covered in these time intervals, here 7 meter, 4 meter, here 12 meter, 2 meter, 4 meter, here 3 meter. These distances covered are unequal in equal intervals of time. So according to definition of non-uniform motion, this object So what we conclude? We conclude that the object A is performing uniform motion and object B is performing non-uniform motion. Now let us switch over to the next activity, that is 8.6. In this activity, we have to measure the time it takes you to walk from your house to your bus stop or the school. If you consider that your average walking speed is 4 km per hour, estimate the distance of the bus stop or school from your house. So this is an experiment to do, but let us suppose here that it takes 0.5 hour, that is half an hour, to walk from house to a bus stop. Suppose the Gotan bus stop, if you go from the LKS school to the Gotan bus stop, it takes hardly 30 minutes, that is half an hour, okay, estimated time. So then the distance of the bus stop from the school will be given by, you know, the formula to calculate the speed is V is equal to this S upon T, as the distance covered upon the time taken. So the average walking speed is given to you, that is V is given to you, and the time, approximate time we have taken, half an hour. So V is equal to S by T, so S will be equal to this V into T. So S will equal to V into T is equal to, now put the value of V, that is given to you 4 km per hour, multiplied by time, the estimated time we have taken, assumed 0.5 hour. So when we multiplied, we get 2.0, that is 2 km. So the bus stop from our school is approximately 2 km. So this was activity 8.6. And next time, we will do the next activity. Thank you.